Previous video we have seen about consideration. In this video we are going to see about void agreement. It is classified into 11 points. First one is made with incompetent person is also void. Agreement made with a bilateral mistake is void. 11 section 20. Agreement the consideration which is unlawful is also void. Section 23. Next is section 24 is agreement of consideration which is unlawful in part. Next, where the agreement without consideration, it's also void, section 25, but there are some exceptions we have seen in our last video in unit 2. Agreement in restraint of trade, this 6 points are new to us. Agreement in restraint of marriage, 26, in restraint of trade, 27, in restraint of legal proceeding, 28. Agreement the meaning which is uncertain is 29. Wagering agreement is 30. Agreement to do an impossible act, this we are going to see in next chapter. Up to wagering agreement we are going to see in this chapter. Agreement in restraint of marriage means comes under section 26, which states that when one person gets money for not to be married, when there is a contract between A and B, when A and B agree to marry, but when C enters and gave A some money to not marry to B, it is a void agreement. Next, agreement in restraint of trade, this means we can see with this example, agreement in restraint of trade is not valid, but in some cases it is valid. In this example, B, a physician and a surgeon employs A as an assistant for the terms of 3 years, and A agrees not to practice as a surgeon and a physician during these 3 years. The agreement is valid and A can be restrained by injunction if he starts independent practice during this period. When A starts independent practice within these 3 years, then B will sue A for damages or for damages. Next, third point is agreement in restraint of legal proceeding. An agreement in restraint of legal proceeding means when we should not interference with the cases which are going on in the court, but in some cases the court will appoint some person that is called attributor. In case of attribution, arbitration, the court will appoint some person arbitrator, I think so. He will dispute, that is the both party will talk each other and take on mutual decision. It is valid. Next, agreement the meaning which is uncertain. In previously we have seen the agreement must be certain. The uncertain agreements is void. It comes under section 29. Next, wagering agreement. Wagering is nothing but it is like gambling. Gambling we can see with this example. A agrees to pay 50,000 to B if it rains, and B promised to pay a like amount to A if it does not rain. The agreement will be by way of wager because it involves money. A and B involved. It involves the event of happening and not happening. If it rains, A would pay. If it not rains, B would pay A. Then there are essentials elements of a wager. They are there must involve money or money's worth. It must be event of happening or not happening. It must be uncertainty. Next, it must involve two parties. Each party must stand to win or lose. Either one party must win or another party should lose. The both party have a common interest at the time of making an agreement. They have common intention to bid at the time of making such agreement. Next, party should have no interest in the event. The one party, in this case, one party can't control that event. They have no interest upon that event. Except for stake transactions similar to wager, that is gambling. These four transactions are similar to wager. First one is lottery transaction. Even though it is approved by Government of India, it is one of a wager. Next, crossword puzzle and competition. In this case it is a wager because the answers previously prepared and kept by the editor of the newspaper. But it is not wager it is not a wedge. According to Price Competition Act, Price Competition Act 1955, price competition in games of skill are not wager provided that the prize money does not exceed rupees 1000. If the prize money exceeds rupees 1000, it is called wager. If it is below 1000, it is not a wager. Speculative transaction. Here, when the parties intend to settle a difference between a contract price and a market price of certain goods, it is called gambling and it is void. Horse race transaction. In this transactions, the winning price must not be less than 500. If it is less than 500, it is wager. If it is more than 500, it is not a wager. Next, transactions resembling with wager transaction but not void. Some transactions are like wagering but approved by the government of India and not void. Like chit fund. Chit fund means many persons may join together and contribute some amount monthly, and their names are written in a paper, and lucky drawn or lucky winner will get that whole amount of that person's monthly. Simultaneously, the other person will get in next month, other person will get in next month. Commercial transaction. In India, speculative transaction in all over the world, it is not considered as a wager. Game of skill and athletic competition, where the game of skill is involved, the according to Price Competition Act 1955, the price amount should not exceed rupees 1000, it is valid. If it is exceed 1000, it is wagering. Contract of insurance. In case of contract of insurance, it is a type of contingent happen, the event of happening or not happening. In contract of insurance, like we can take health insurance policy, when you affected by some disease and you win, go to hospital, we can claim. It is called contingent event. Either it may happen or not happen. That's all for this video. Here there gave one distinguish between a contract of insurance and a wagering contract. This is so simple, we can read it by understanding and understand it by reading. That's all for this video. To subscribe to this channel, in next video we are going to revise unit 3 fully. Subscribe to the channel so you will not miss out any videos from our channel. Please follow the Telegram channel. I will upload all the notes in that channel. Thank you.